Hello students, I'm Kiran Shinde, Assistant Professor IICMR MCA. Welcome to the video lecture on Issues in Cloud Computing Part 3. And first of all, thank you for watching my previous two videos, Issues in Cloud Computing Part 1 and Part 2. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss about the risks involved in data migration where we ended our Part 2 video. So here we are going to discuss again about the three types of data validation: sample data validation, subset of data validation, and complete data set validation. So sample data validation basically involves in random selection of the record from legacy system or the source system and comparing the same with target system. Here in this method, we cannot assure that 100% of the data will be migrated without any error, because here we are actually selecting the random records out of the legacy system and comparing those random records with the target system. Let us discuss about subset of data validation. This is the second type of data migration, that is subset of data validation. In this method, instead of random sample, we choose subset of records which are based on row number, for example, first 1000 records or first 10,000 records to 50,000 records likewise. So here we can expect more data coverage as compared to sample data validation. And the third type is complete data set validation. It is an ideal validation method which is used in migration testing. It basically compares every record in bidirectional way, that is comparing every record in legacy system against the target system. So it is more appropriate and more accurate method of validation, I can say data set validation, which is extensively used in migration testing. Now let us discuss about streaming in cloud. What do you mean by streaming in cloud? Streaming is nothing but a technique for transferring data so that it can be processed as a steady and continuous stream. So essentially, data streaming can also be explained as a technology which is used to deliver content to devices over the internet and which allows to access the content immediately, means without waiting for it to be downloaded. So streaming technologies are becoming increasingly important with the growth of internet, because most users do not have fast enough access to download the large multimedia files quickly. So it actually gives, it actually gives that ease to the user to watch the data which is required by them without downloading it. With streaming, the client browser or plugin can start displaying the data before the entire file has been transmitted. So now let us discuss some examples based on data streaming. Basically, data streaming includes e-commerce purchases, in-game player activities, information from social networks or financial trading information, etc. Some more examples are listed here. Sensors in transportation vehicles, industrial equipment and farm machinery send data to a streaming application. The application monitors performance, detects any potential defects in advance and places a spare part order, automatically preventing equipment downtime. A financial institution which tracks changes in the stock market in real time. A real estate website which tracks a subset of data from consumers, mobile devices, and make real time property recommendations of properties to visit based on their geolocation. So these are certain examples where data streaming is very, very important. Some more examples to make you understand the topic even more deeper. Solar power company has to maintain power throughput for its customers or pay penalties. It has implemented a streaming data application that monitors of all of panels in the field and schedules services in real time. So there are many more fields which are actually finding this data streaming very, very important. And last, we will take one more example here. An online gaming company which collects streaming data about player game interactions and feeds the data into its gaming platform. So it then analyzes the data in real time and offers incentives and dynamic experiences to engage its players. So you can see like many more industries are finding this data streaming very helpful for their businesses. Now let us discuss a very important term which is involved under issues in cloud computing, that is IDS, which is intrusion detection system. An IDS or intrusion detection system is a device or software application that monitors a network or system for malicious activity or policy violations. So basically it is a kind of system which continuously observes or monitors the network traffic for any kind of malicious activity. Any detected activity or violation is typically reported either to an administrator or collected centrally using SIEM, that is Security Information and Event Management. What is SIEM? It is a system that combines output from various sources and uses alarm filtering techniques to distinguish malicious activity from false alarms. Now, let us discuss the types of IDS here. The first type of intrusion detection system is network IDS. Now, network IDS or NIDS are placed at a strategic point or points within the network to monitor the traffic to and from all devices on the network. Essentially, we can take an example of a firewall. Like basically, firewall is placed in between the external and the internal traffic flows. So it performs an analysis of passing traffic on the entire subnet and matches the traffic that is passed on the subnets to the library of known attacks. And once an attack is identified or abnormal behaviorally sensed, the alert can be sent to the administrator. It is very simple to understand. Like for example, if we place a firewall in between the internal network and the external network, then maybe this IDS will work as a kind of alarming system to detect any malicious activity maybe entering to the network or maybe it is transmitting across your network. So an example of an IDS would be installing it on the subnet where firewalls are located. Just now I just mentioned about this. Now the second type of IDS is host IDS. Host IDS is host intrusion detection system which run on individual hosts or devices on the network. Now a simple example of this can be an antivirus which is installed individually or a Windows firewall which is set individually on every device or every machine on a network. One more point we need to discuss here. An example of HIDS usage can be seen on mission critical machines which are not expected to change their configuration. Now let us understand what are mission critical systems or mission critical machines. Now these are machines which are, for example, it can be an online banking system, railway/aircraft operating and control systems, electric power systems that will typically adversely affect the business if they fail. So these are the examples of mission critical machines onto which this HIDS works very, very importantly. Now let us talk about IDS in cloud computing. Cloud computing is one of the most vulnerable targets, as we know. So Klaber and Schulter have proposed an IDS service at cloud middleware layer, which has an audit system. Now we will try to understand this particular concept with a simple diagram also after this slide. The architecture of IDS service includes essentially node, service, event auditor and storage. So let us understand what are these four factors. First, the node contains resources that are accessed through middleware, which defines access control policies. Service, which facilitates the communication, and event auditor is the main system which monitors and captures the data. Now let us look at this particular diagram. This is a simple diagram explaining about the three major components involved in IDS in cloud. You can see this is the first entity, which is cloud user organization or cloud user infrastructure. This is second, that is CSP, cloud service provider infrastructure. And this is the third and very important entity, that is third party IDS monitoring and advisory service. So in this particular diagram, you can just see that this particular entity, which is called as IDS monitoring and advisory service, it monitors continuously whatever data traffic is going through the cloud user organization or the cloud user infrastructure from and to the CSP infrastructure. And at this stage, if it actually analyzes any kind of malicious activity happening here, then it will send the advisory report to the CSP about that malicious activity. So these are certain points where the IDS in cloud works very, very effectively. Thank you. Thank you, students. Hope you have understood the concept. Stay tuned for my next video. Thank you.